Hi, this is a computer power supply. Different output voltages are produced in this device. Each output is used for a part of the computer motherboard. To turn on this device, without connecting to the motherboard, we need to disconnect the green wire to the black wire. This connection should not be interrupted. The device is turned on and the fan starts rotating. But if the smallest connecting is made in the output section, the device is turned off and there is no more voltage in the output. Until we disconnect the device from the city electricity and reconnect it to the city electricity. In this case, the device will restart. But why does this happen? This issue is related to the overvoltage protection circuit. The computer motherboard is very sensitive to voltage fluctuation or changes in input voltages. Therefore, the smallest change in the voltage of the power supply will cause damage to the motherboard. In this video, we will fully examine the overvoltage protection circuit according to the schematic. Well, let's see how it works. I turn on the power supply. This tool is only for testing output voltages. It does not check the output current. Red wire 5 volts, yellow wire 12 volts, orange wire 3.3 volts, green wire 5 volts, gray wire 5 volts, the same power good. If these voltages are present, it means that the output voltages are not a problem. But we have to check its proper functioning by connecting it to the motherboard. Well, now we will check the overvoltage protection circuit according to the schematic. This is the schematic of the 200 watt power supply model PTP2038. This is the standby or startup section. This is the main transformer. This is a drive transformer. These two are the main transistor of the inverter section. This is the output section and Schottky diodes. This op-amp IC is used as a supervisor. This IC is TL494 for pulse generation. This is the part of the overvoltage protection circuit that we focus on. IC TL494 creates two pulses on pin 8 and 11. A voltage of 5 volts is generated in pin 14. We call this reference voltage. When I turn on the device, the standby section is activated. Two voltages are generated at the output. One is 5 volts, which we also call VSV, and is created on the purple wire. This voltage is sent to activate the supervisor IC. The second voltage can be up to 21 volts, depending on the type of device. This voltage is sent to turn on the IC TL494. The same voltage reaches to pulse amplifier transistor and the middle head of the drive transformer. So, these two transistors are always on, and when the pulse is generated, they turn off. Three voltages are also required to produce power good. First, 5 volt standby voltage. Second, 5 volt reference voltage from IC TL494. Third, 5 volt output voltage. These three voltages together create power good. Well, now we want to check that when the output voltages such as 5, 12, minus 12, and 3.3 volts fluctuate or are interrupted, how the device detects the incorrect voltage and interrupts the outputs. When the device is connected to the city electricity, the standby part will turn on. It's like connecting the mobile charger to the city electricity. The charger generates voltage at the output without pressing any key. For this reason, when you are not using the computer, always turn off the button on the back of the device to deactivate the standby section. Well, the standby section produces two voltages. One is 5 volt and the second voltage is for the TL494 IC. Pin 12 receives the voltage and the IC turns on. When the voltage reaches the IC, a voltage of 5 volt is generated at pin 14. Pins 13 and 15 are also connected to this 5 volts. If pin 13 is not connected to 5 volts, only single pulse is generated, while we need two pulses, so pin 13 must be connected to pin 14. So, how does this switching power supply start working? When we press the power button on the front of the computer case, the green wire is connected to the black wire. We call the green wire PS on. If we want to turn on the power supply without the computer motherboard, we must keep the green wire connected to the black wire. If this connection is broken, the power supply is turned off. But in the motherboard, the existence of internal communication makes this connection always remain active. Here, PS on is placed. Its voltage is 5 volts. This voltage is prepared by a standby. This line will be 0 volts when connected to 0 volts. The presence of 0 voltage in the base pin of the NPN transistor will cause it to turn off. The emitter is connected to ground. So, when the transistor was on, the ground reached the base of transistor Q1 through the emitter collector. This is a PNP transistor, so this transistor was on. When the transistor turns off, there is no more connection between the emitter and the collector, and the ground is removed from the collector. This line is no longer ground and this PNP transistor turns off. A capacitor is placed here. When the base of this transistor is grounded, this capacitor is slowly discharged and causes this transistor to turn off slowly. This means that the conductance between the emitter and the collector decreases slowly. For this reason, the second transistor is gradually turned off. So, what's the point of this? The reference voltage of 5 volts is connected to the emitter of this transistor through this path. So, there are 5 volts in the emitter. The collector of this transistor is connected to pin number 4 of ICTL494. What is the role of pin number 4? Pin 4 is the dead time control between IC pulses. The higher this amount, the shorter the pulse width on pin 8 and 11. And in the same way, the pulse amplifier transistors receive a lower voltage. Therefore, the time when the transistor is on is reduced. So, what happened? I want to introduce the sponsor of the video, PCBWay.com. Everything that is in your mind becomes a reality here. Order it to be made and enjoy. Well, let's go back to the video. When the green wire is connected to the black, the first transistor will gradually turn off, due to the presence of this capacitor. The second transistor is gradually turned off and the voltage of 5 volts will reach pin 4, less and less from this path. This cycle is the same as soft start in switching power supplies. If the voltage on pin 4 is low, the pulse width on pin 8 and 11 increases and the device turns on. Well, in this case, the power supply is turned on. The pulses generated from the IC reach the drive transformer with the help of these two transistors. And after being amplified, they reach the base pin of the main transistors. The main transformer uses a half-bridge topology. Cutting and connecting the current in the primary coil causes magnetic induction in the secondary coil, and the appropriate voltage is created. This voltage enters Schottky diodes and is rectified. It will then be stored in capacitors. These voltages include 5, 12, 3.3 and minus 12. 3.3 voltage is important. For this purpose, there is a separate circuit to stabilize this voltage. In this case, there are voltage outputs. For any reason, if one of these voltages fluctuates or its value increases or decreases, how does the circuit detect it? Now, we are going to check the protection circuit. The voltages of the output section are located here. All these voltages are collected at this point. This is a separate section and this is another section. For any reason, if one of these voltages has a problem, a voltage will be generated here, which will go from this pad to the base of transistor Q6, which is an NPN transistor. This transistor will turn on. The emitter of this transistor is connected to ground, so the ground will reach this point through the collector. Zero voltage reaches the base of PNP transistor, the same transistor Q5. The emitter of this transistor is connected to 5V reference from this pass, same as pin 14. So there is 5V on the emitter. When the transistor is turned on, 5V goes through the collector and through this pass, and through this diode to pin 4 of the IC, and increases the dead time. That is, any change in the output voltages of the device will cause transistor Q6 to turn on. And as a result, transistor Q5 will turn on, and the reference voltage of 5V will reach pin 4 of the IC. But there is another issue. The voltage of 5V, which is on the collector of transistor Q5, enters diode D12 through this pass, and reaches the base pin of transistor Q6 through this resistance. This makes transistor always on. For this reason, when there is a problem with the output voltages, have to disconnect the device from the city power and reconnect it to the city power so that this transistor turns off and the device can turn on again. What is the role of this diode D11 in the circuit? The voltage of 5V reaches pin 4 of the IC from this pass. Well, there is also a voltage in this pass. This diode prevents the voltage in this path from going to transistor Q5. There are two other diodes, D9 and D27. The voltage of 5V in the emitter of transistor Q5, which must reach the base of transistor Q6, these diodes prevent these 5V created in the reference pin from being connected to the output voltages of the device. Well, that was a brief explanation of the overvoltage protection circuit. When the protective circuit is activated, the power good will also be cut off. Thank you for your time to watch the video.